For our veterans today, we are talking about something that we're going to have some fun with. Sometimes the stuff we talk about is pretty serious, but today we're having some fun. Today we're going to have Chandra Boyd and Lori Kennedy. Lori and Chandra, thank you for being here today, guys. Appreciate it. First, Chandra, tell me how this whole thing got started, where you guys are helping veterans kind of get in touch with their artistic side.
We are. That's cool. So the Oklahoma Arts Council, we launched an arts and military initiative in 2015. And we recognized a need across our state that arts programs could serve our service members and their families. And so as we built that initiative, we needed a really great partner. And so we reached out to the Oklahoma Department of Veterans Affairs, and that led to our pilot.
That totally makes sense. Kind of giving the nuts and bolts of this, exactly what kind of arts are you guys doing?
Sure. So we, as a pilot, it's a great opportunity to experiment.
True.
And so we took it down to Norman Veterans Center, and we were able to partner with some Norman Community Arts Resources, Firehouse Arts Center.
Of course.
And we placed professional artists in the facility,
really?
And they were teaching college-level courses in photography, creative writing, and visual arts.
So you're bringing in instructors. This isn't just about saying, here's some supplies, go at it, right?
Right. Awesome. We really wanted the professionalism.
Totally awesome. Let's talk a little bit about some of our vets, Lori, and you've been seeing these guys as they've been getting into it down in Norman, and it's exciting. You're getting ready to start it in Lawton. We're showing some pictures right here. You know, how does this help our guys and gals?
Well, we've had amazing results with this because we've had residents that maybe just really didn't want to participate in any activities. They didn't care what was going on.
Mm-hmm.
And now they're painting and they're writing and they're just doing all these wonderful things. But what we found is they're starting to communicate with each other. I'm meeting out to a resident that I didn't know, and now I'm talking with staff members that I didn't know. So we saw these great improvements in just self-esteem and self-pride in the projects, because being on a kind of a college level, that's something that we kind of was a real kind of a surprise to all of us. But
I think we all know some older veterans who don't communicate.
Yes.
They don't want to talk about their experiences. Maybe this opens the door.
This actually did open the door, because that's what we found as we started off with photography. So some of them just kind of sat back and watched. And as we moved on to painting and creative writing, they started participating.
Mm-hmm.
They started telling stories. And at the end, they were telling stories that nobody even knew about. They were painting just with these incredible pictures.
That's
that will
awesome.
Be, they were actually, we had displayed at the Firehouse Arts Center professionally.
Oh, really?
So everything was done on a professional level.
That is so awesome.
The change in attitude that we saw in all the residents was amazing, but it also spilled over into our staff. So now we had staff involvement and staff motivation, because somebody's now coming to do a project.
Right.
They want to get up, they want to stay independent, they look forward to class, and now we have family members that are coming.
That's totally awesome.
So
that's great.
I get to see what my dad painted.
Right, that's fun.
It's actually something so I can bring my grandchild up here and they can participate in the arts program.
Get the whole family involved.
The whole family.
It's really an awesome program.
Yes.
I'm glad you guys have teamed up to do this. I hope to see it spread to the other VA centers that we have around. It's great. Thank you guys for being here today.
Thank you.
If you want to get involved with this, or maybe ask about if it can come to your center, you can contact the Oklahoma Department of Veteran Affairs. They do such great work. They help out everybody. And any other questions you might have from them, make sure you get all the benefits you deserve for being a veteran for us. And more to come. Keep it right here on News Channel 4.